I identify as a male, and I have recently come to the realization that I have red S. Now, I know from a previous video that males can have red S, but it feels like everything is tailored towards women. What would you tell someone like me who is struggling with this? Because I feel like I'm the only one out there.
Yeah, I empathize with this because, yes, the literature primarily did focus on women in the earlier stages, those that identify as women. But as we have grown to learn and as we have had athletes that have expressed this current concern, that has helped us expand. And truth be told, I think because the menstrual cycle is an easy thing to check off, that you're having one, not having one, I think that was a starting point. But being able to understand physiology, that obviously males' bodies are going to respond in a similar manner to low energy availability and have some of those health consequences. So I hope that they are able to stand forward. And we do have researchers out there that are starting to focus on males. So it's only a matter of time before you'll see more emphasis and possibly even different screening and assessment.
What would you tell people who identify as male to keep an extra eye on as they begin their recovery process? As with women, it's often, yeah, menstrual cycles or cervical fluid, or what would you say for males to keep an eye on?
Yeah, I like the interchange of calling it either reproductive health or sexual health. Both of those are very important. So for males, it could be a drop in the amount of morning erections that they consistently would have, or even a decreased sex drive. There is some exploration right now, if they are seeking to have children, that males also be assessed for infertility, because we know that sperm count will be decreased in that low energy availability state. So that might be three ways that they can be able to assess where their sexual health is at that time.
Okay. And then the other symptoms we've talked about, loss of feeling cold in extremities, and irritability, insomnia, stomach upsets, those apply to everyone and can also be monitored.
Absolutely. That doesn't seem to differ between the females and the males as well. Again, seeing some of that digestive dysfunction, especially being able to take nutrition in during training, body temperature and bone stress injuries. While the statistics may be higher in females, we are seeing those just as rampant in males in the low energy availability state.
Okay, thank you.